Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Conquest of Sarpadia for Zelda Classic, the final part! Yes, we're gonna wrap up Phyrexia and the Phyrexian Tower today, in addition to defeating Volrath and saving Zelda from certain doom again. Anyways, let's finish this bad boy! Alrighty, the first item of business is locating the golden arrows. Let's get to it. And to locate them, we want to go south. I'm going to stick around and kill some of the Lynels, get some health back too. We're going to have more Death Knight and Death Octi encounters shortly. And I want to prep myself for them. Hey, very nice. I'll definitely take that. Alright, got over half my health back already. This is awesome. Alright, another heart. Good, I'll take that. Alright, we want to get on this screen, get the hammer out, and go to town on these bushes because we have a hidden hole amongst one of them. Right here. Alright, ignore the bats and go through this locked door. And slowly pick off the bat robes in this room. Oh, crap, it was a stopwatch. Oh, well. Yeah, what I suggest you do is just kill one bat robe, leave the room, come back, and rinse, lather, repeat. Trust me, you'll save yourself heartache and a headache. I don't know why I said heartache, I meant headache, but whatever. You got the idea. Anyways, just keep picking off the bat robes like I'm doing. Oh, man. Yeah, I don't want the bats to accumulate. Gets very annoying. Ooh, stopwatch, I'll use it here. I kill the remainder of the bats before the stopwatch stops. And walk into my hammer! Alright, more blue Lynels coming out of this cave. Wax them all. Wax on, bastard. Wax on! Wax off! Haha! Alright, on this screen, Biter Snakes, Octoroks, and Moblins. Kill them all. Alright, all the way back to full health. Nice. I'm ready for all the nasties of Phyrexia now. Alright, this screen, gotta take it easy here. Got some Death Octis, and down here, we're going to locate, I believe, our final mana jar of the game. It's the center bush, you got to hammer it down. There we go. Here is another mana jar for you. Thank you, kind old man. Alrighty. That about does it for life boost and magic boost. I really don't know if there was two more mana jars somewhere in Phyrexia or the regular overworld of Sarpadia, but if there was, sorry I missed them, guys. I don't know where to find the last two if there are other ones. Okay, now we want to go find the golden arrows. And the cave for the golden arrows are up here. Is up here. Just want to kill the Death Octis. I need one more ruby to purchase the golden arrows. Boom, dead. You die. Magic potion, don't need it. Here, Biter, Snake, Octoroks. Yeah, these guys will drop rubies. They're very good at dropping them. Alright, that'll do it. 502's just enough. Why? Because the golden arrows are worth 501. Alright, that's our second item collected in Phyrexia. Alright, the next item in our crosshairs is going to be the spike boots, so let's go find them. I'm gonna dodge the magic Octis there. Alright, screw you blue Lynels, I'm done. Alrighty. Yeah, thankfully those Death Octis can't swim. Yeah, this toxic wastewater doesn't look too appealing. And while you're on the raft, do not hold down any buttons, because sometimes you'll glitch yourself coming off the raft on this certain path. You'll get stuck between a ground tile and a water tile. Once you're on the water tile like this, just push forward and you'll get back on land. Very easy to get stuck if you're not careful. Kinda wish Alpha Dog fixed the landing a little better, but eh, what could you do? Anyways, on this screen, you got some Death Knights. But they're trapped between bushes, so they're not much of a threat. You can pick them off rather easily. And dead. Now let's go through here. Alright, now we're back on this screen where I was originally trying to look for a hole in the last part. And it's actually down on this screen here. Get rid of this Death Octi first. I don't want him getting in the way of my hammering. It's Hema time! I think the hole was somewhere over here. It was in this row, I think. Alright, maybe not that row, maybe it's this one. And... okay, not quite yet. Might be this row, perhaps. I know the hole somewhere. Ah, here we go. Alrighty, on this screen, we got Blue Wiz Robes. Gonna ignore them. Nothing happens there. Alright, here we got a Rapid Fire Goma. Get your golden arrows ready. Takes 3 hits to bring it down. Open your eye and die! Haha! And that golden ruby, I believe, gives us 100 or 200 or 150, I don't know. Looks like it's 200 rubies. Nice. I'm very happy with that drop. Alright, Blue Darkness, I don't even know why I'm killing him. I don't need health. Alright, here we got 2 Death Knights. We get our 3rd item here after killing them. Yeah, pretty easy room. Death Knights are stuck between rocks. And we get the Spike Boots. Awesome. Now we can backtrack to where that Petra 2 was and go through that spike-filled room. Yeah, first we gotta deal with the Mirror Robes. Oh god, ah, crap. Yeah, they do 2 hearts of damage if they hit you. So they sort of hurt even with the red mail. But with the gold ring, the damage will be reduced by a ton. Only do 1 heart of damage. But thankfully, you got so much room to work with on these mirror robes. So they shouldn't really be too much of a threat. Anyways, Raft Path, let's go. Gotta be extremely careful coming off this path too. Because it's gonna drop us right off in front of these Death Knights. So you gotta be exceptionally careful coming off that water. You might be swallowing a crap ton of swords. Alrighty, Death Knights are dead. And I don't think we need to go that... actually, yes we do. We have to go back this way. Alrighty, Rue. Wait a minute. No, we don't. We have to go up. Yeah, because that cave up north is going to take us back to the Windrobe room, which in turn will take us towards the Petra 2 room and the Spike room. It's slowly coming back to me. Haven't played this game in a couple days. Taking a while for my brain to remember where everything is exactly. Alrighty, Windrobes, just skip right past them and go down. And be careful, the Spike Boots will drain your mana. So you want to move very quick. You don't want to stay on the spikes too long. Woohoo. Alright, got out of there in due time. In good time, due time, whatever. Alright, on this screen we got regular bats. That's not too threatening. Or regular aches. And down here we have Blue Wiz Robes. But really, they're a joke by this point. I haven't even taken a hit from one yet. Look how ridiculously easy they are now. Alright, let's go through this locked door, see what we have here. Actually, I think there was something more important over here to the left. Alright, got some Wizrobe bats here, or Wizrobe aches. I love the Sword of Ages, I love the Sword of Ages. Alright, what you want to do is get the bomb and blow open the wall here. Yeah, we got some red aches in here which turn into Megmats if you don't kill them fast. I think there's only really a key to be found in here. And since we got the magical key, it's kind of a waste of time. But I just wanted to show this off to you guys. Alrighty, now let's go to the left. Alright, and here we got two rapid... not two rapid fire gomas. We got 2 Goma 3s. I think it takes 2 golden arrows to waste them. Ah, crap. They close their eyes too damn fast. Ah, god. I think I might have gotten rid of one, maybe. Alright, one more hit on Goma 3 and it should be dead. And then we can proceed through the locked door. And we only get a key, but you know what, screw it. And here we got 1 lone Death Knight. And we're just gonna wait for him to come to us. Because then he'll just get stuck. He won't be able to hit us with his sword from here. So take advantage of that. And we get the hook shot. Awesome. Alrighty, I think we only need a few more items. I think we still need the level 2 bracelet. We also need the golden ring. And I think that might be it. I could be wrong, though. Alrighty, Rue, let's go back through here to the Super Duck Nut Room. There'll be a set of staircases out. A staircase. That'll just take you to another portion of Phyrexia. Take out all these Super Dark Nuts that are left. You know what? I can afford to tank these guys now. I'm not too afraid. Alrighty, and this Wrath Path will take us to somewhere new. And this one takes us to a flame-breathing Gliok. Four-headed. You die now. Alright, that Gliok's dead. I don't think there's anything underneath these bushes, so just continue north. And here we got a hookshot path. Yeah, just zip around with the hookshot. And over here we got a brand new raft path, which will take us north. So hold the up button. And this in turn will take us towards the level 2 bracelet. Oh yeah, well, there's also another item I forgot. Yeah, we got the cross too, the amulet. Cross, amulet, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, there's actually invisible enemies in this game. As if this game was tough enough already, now we got invisible enemies. Eek. Alrighty, over here are more death octies. Whoa, crap, yeah. Not gonna deal with that. Or maybe I do. Because there's actually a hidden hole somewhere over here on one of these screens. God, I don't want these guys humming on me. I'm going to stay over here where they can't get at me. Alright, now they're dead. Alright, let's look for this hidden hole. Aha! Alright, and here we fight some scatter robes. Not too bad. I killed over half of them already. Try and get some health back. Bam, dead. And down here, what do we have? Okay, wind robes, let's go up north. What do we have here? Alright, blue gorillas, that's not a big threat. Kill them all with my golden sword. Alright, watch out on this screen, you got four death octies. Kill them all this way, and we get a super bomb. Awesome. Awesome, Blossom. Yeah, I know, wrong game. This isn't PPGs, but hey, I felt like saying it. Have to keep myself amused while I kill all these deadly enemies. Alright, let's go right. Oh, more blue wizard robes. And he phased right into me, that son of a bitch. Alright, blue duck nuts. Yeah, these guys are an absolute joke. I yawn at these guys, they're pathetic. Alright, over here. You want a super bomb. And there's another very important item we can find here. Boom! And enter this cave. Sorry, I had to reinforce my door. Volrath's minions would do anything to get their hands on this. Yes, the level 4 armor, the gold ring. Oh yeah, we are godlike now for sure. Even mirror robes aren't going to be able to pierce us very good. Only a heart of damage at most now. And Death Knight swords won't be so threatening anymore either. I mean, they're still going to do solid damage, at least 2 to 3 hearts. But we can take the hits a lot better now. Alrighty, now with the golden ring in our possession. And the scatter robes are back. But not for long. Alrighty, 2 different paths we can take here, left or right. I think the right path is going to take us to the power bracelet level 2, so let's do that. Alright, I got some fire robes. Try to keep your distance against these guys. Spam sword beams. Sword to the face! Right, I'm shooting the wrong way, Link. Ay ay ay. Alright, next screen over we have Patra 3! Eeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee Yes, Petra 3s are... Yeah, they are monsters. But thankfully, I can stay over here and dodge pretty much all the beam fire. Oh, God. Now, let me try to inch my way over here. Stay on the edge of the street so I can dodge all the beams. Alright. Let's see if I can flawless a Petra 3. That... Oh, God! I knew that was going to happen. So I have to stay at the very edge of the screen to avoid all the beams. Oh god. Yeah, that Petra's kid's gonna hit me. Go backwards, Petra 3, not forward. Oh god, oh god. It's coming at me again. Backwards, damn it. No! Not forward. Backward, Petra, backward. Ay, ay, ay. He likes moving forward. Alright, finally, he's going backward now. I just gotta hope that Petra stays in my line of fire. Oh no, he's coming forward. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Crap. Might be a while. This Petra's very unpredictable. As long as the kids don't hit me, I'll be fine. Come on, a little further south, please. Alright, let me get this. Ah! Come on, sword beams. Don't miss. Ah! Oh my god, my aim is lousy. There we go. Now I can kill the inner circle. Once this Petra shoots off less beams, I'll run in and finish him off. I'm obsessed with getting this flawless. Hey, you know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna go in. I feel comfortable killing it now. I don't want to waste time either. I want to get this game a-going. Alright, Petra 3, you are dead. Level 2 power bracelet is mine. Alrighty, I think there's only two more items to locate. We have to find the fire boomerang, which is actually a battle axe in this game. And we also got to find the amulet. And that should be everything. And then we'll be ready for the Phyrexian Tower. Alright, Miro, meet your doom! And gloom! Yeah, eat your own magic and like it. Come on, one more magic shot. Come on, bitch, turn around. Haha! Owned! Yeah, we appear outside this cave. And I believe we are now ready to make our way towards Phyrexian Tower, because the battle axe and the amulet are pretty close to it. Oh, yeah, let me get out of here. Run, run, run. Oh god, there's mirror robes on... Oh, not mirror robes, death octies on all these screens. Yeah, I think I'm gonna stay at the edge of the screen and wait for them to come at me. Their magic spells will be just out of my reach. Come on, boomerang. Oh, yeah, you gotta stop missing it. There we go. Dead. Alrighty, now we gotta find... Aha, we gotta go up north. Because this is gonna be like a, it's gonna be like another three-stair warp room that's gonna take us to, like, a whole different area of Phyrexia, where the Phyrexian Tower is, and the last two items. So, not much more to go, folks. Phyrexian Tower shouldn't take any more than 15 minutes. So we should have this part done, hopefully, within 40 minutes. I don't care. Take a hit. Go. Alright, we gotta push one of these rocks, and that'll take us to a three-stair warp room. Choose your destiny. Okay, this is the wrong one. I know where the right one is. I'll know it when I see it. Oh, this is it. This is it for sure. Next screen over, another rapid-fire Goma. He's essentially guarding the entrance to the Phyrexian Tower. Alright, two more hits on this rapid-fire Goma, he'll be dead. God, I hate spiders. Alright, rapid-fire Goma dead, let's continue. Yeah, going right will take you to Phyrexian Tower. You want to go up first. Because we got the amulet to find over here. And watch out, I think we got another Death Knight up here. You want to position yourself a certain way to hit him. Just so you're out of his beam fire range. Come on, Death Knight, down here. Alright, once the Death Knight is dead, get your whistle out and blow it. Super secret awesome staircase. Yeah. You will need this just to see most of the enemies inside Phyrexian Tower, let alone vanquish them. Thank you, old man, for this handy-dandy cross. And if you go up north another screen, there'll actually be an old man that'll tell you his battle axe got lost behind the tower somewhere. And he'll actually give you a red potion. And considering I don't have one, yeah, I'm gonna go grab it right now. A red potion would be most appreciated at this point. I lost my battle axe somewhere around Phyrexian Tower. You should try to find it, as it will help you greatly during your ascent. For now, all I have for you is this. Thank you, kind old man, for this red potion. Alrighty, folks, let's go to Phyrexian Tower and finally finish this game. And Alpha Dog, I hope I did your LP, or hope I did your game justice. Blah, not LP. Wrong phrase, wrong word there. That's if he's even watching. I left him a message on Facebook letting him know I was doing his game, but he hasn't responded yet, so I don't know if he'll ever get around to seeing it. Anyways, let's kill these wind robes. Because they're actually guarding the entrance to the Phyrexian Tower. Couple more hits and they're dead. Well, this one. Boom. Gone. And just keep going up north and you'll get there. And here's the Phyrexian Tower, but first go behind it and find the battle axe. There it is. AKA the Fire Boomerang. You can stun Bubbles and Wizrobes now. Very, very useful. And you can stun Death Knights if you catch them from the backside. Alright, now to enter Phyrexian Tower, hack the door down. Enter. Phyrexian Tower, first floor. This music's pretty epic. Anyone knows the knows this theme, please let me know in the comments below. Yeah, there's multiple ways you can go in Phyrexian Tower. I prefer going north, coming in. And the best thing about the battle axe is you can stun these damn eyeballs. You don't have to wait for them to keep moving anymore. Ah, stop wandering in the water. And in here, we got a flame Leoc. Gonna stay in the doorway and spam my sword beams. And boy, the fire is barely missing me. Ah, crap. Curse you, Gliok. Die. For your insolence. Alright, in this room we have... Oh god, really? Pole's voice in Darknuts? That's kind of a joke for the last level in the game. Bunny hunting, we will go then. Ah, crap, I forgot I can't use the ladder on the water anymore. I got the friggin' water boots now. Alright, let me just pelt this red dark nut from over across the water. Okay, I guess we're gonna bomb the wall here. And to the right we go. Alright, we got some mirror robes guarding the second floor. Yeah, Volrath, we're gonna own your ass. Like grass. Come on, Mirror Robe, turn around. A few more hits and they should be dead. Come on. Throw some more magic my way, bitch. Ah, crap. Ah, damn it. Thankfully, they only do a heart of damage now, which is not bad. Come on, throw more magic at me. You too, come on. Aha, dead. Now we can go to the north. Phyrexian Tower, second floor. And now that we got the battle axe, we can stun blue wizrobes. Pathetic blue wizrobes. I laugh at your pitifulness. You are nothing to me now. Yeah, go left. Alright, yeah. Be careful. You want to light this room up for one particular reason. Giant-ass hole in the middle of the room. You need to hookshot your way across it, too. Alright, in here. Got some regular aches. Just kill them. Or skip them, whatever you want to do. Alright, now you got 5 Death Octies in here. Just spam the battle axe from the doorway and your sword beams. Before long, you'll kill all the Death Octies in here. Eat my battle axe. Alright, down to 1 Death Octi. I'm feeling lucky. You die. Alright, now we gotta push the block, open up the bottom shutter, and continue down here. Where we have 1 lone Death Knight. Oh boy. But we have a battle axe, so let's try and stun it. And keep your distance in the meantime. Oh boy. Ooh, caught him nicely there. And the Death Knight is dead. Continue south. Phyrexian Tower, 3rd floor. Yeah, Phyrexian Tower is only 5 floors tall. So we're already halfway through. And even the enemies aren't really that bad in here, aside from the Death Knights and the Death Octies. Yeah, once you kill all the enemies in the room, the spikes will go away. Now we got the compass. And in here, Blue Wiz Robes. Again, joke. Please, game, you're making me laugh here, Blue Wiz Robes. Oh, please, even if they hit me, it's doing, like, jack squat now. Alright, let's go up north. And in here, we got some killer bunnies of doom. It's rabbit hunting season for the last time. Yeah, don't push the block in this room. It's gonna take you backwards. Alright, in here, we got some blue Lamolas. Just stay in the doorway and kill them. Spam my battle axe, too, in the meantime. Come on, you Lamolas, get near the door. I love having 2 projectiles to spam. It's amazing. Keep spamming sword beams in the... There we go. Just like that, Lamola's cleaned up. Now in here, got some scatter rooms. Again, stay in the doorway and kill them. You die. Alright, now we go to the south, and in this room we have... Okay, we got fire rooms. That's not bad. A little more threatening than the blue, but not by much. Still haven't lost my sword beams yet, fire robe. Gonna leave that there in case I need it. Let's go south. Really? You have to spawn me right above the Goma 3s. That's just mean. Okay, I'm actually gonna be careful. Okay, whoa. Yeah, I really don't want to suffer any knockback, so... I'm just gonna tank the hits. Or just stay now. I can dodge 1 pretty well. There we go. Goma 3s are dead. Continue to the left. And in here, you got a pretty tricky flame gliok. It's gonna drain your magic because you're standing on the spikes, so you gotta be quick with this gliok. Hurry and kill it. Come on, get on here. Alright, got the blue ruby, and now let's go to the north. Phyrexian Tower, 4th floor. Oh my goodness. Alright, I believe we can go in any direction for this floor. We can go left or right. Just gonna stay in the doorway and kill these, Wizrobe Aches. Yeah, Wizrobe Aches have a tendency of dropping a lot of magic potions, so good way to replenish your mana. Now let's go right. Alright, we got some super dark nuts in here. Now I'm just gonna tank these bitches. I can afford it. Come on, health! Live up to your name! Oh, God. Come on, drop a fairy. Do something for me, come on. Aha, fairy, thank you. Up here, more blue wizrobes. Is this the best you can do, Volrath? I laugh at your horrible attempt to bring me down. Hey, when you got the gold ring, the strongest sword, you have a right to be cocky. Not a lot of enemies are going to be putting a dent in you anymore. You choose, leave your life or your money. I will pay the toll. Thankfully, I have enough. Fifth floor, here we come. And again, more blue wizrobes. Surprise, surprise. Gonna pick them off one at a time as they teleport into this block room. Alright, another blue wizrobe right in my vicinity. You die. Alright, now let's go to the south. Alright, these next few rooms are gonna be kinda tricky. Yeah. So make sure you get your battle axe. This is why you need it. You have to stun these bubbles so they don't knock you into the hole. Try and goad a lot of these bubbles out of the way. Come on, come on, come on. Up here. Stun three of them and get them out of the way. Yeah, slowly make your way through here. Whoa. Alright, got past this room. And in here, you got some dig doggers. So blow that whistle. And throw your battle axe about like you just don't care. Yeah, I'm just gonna stay pointing straight so that way I don't get any knockback. I don't get knocked into the holes, and that would suck. I don't want to have to climb this tower again. Alrighty, in here, there's no holes, but we do have something else to watch out for. With Armoses! And you really don't want to get hit by a red bubble this early. That would just absolutely suck. I'm going to try to go three of these bubbles over here if I can. I'm waiting for one of them to move up, and I guess they're not. Woo! Yeah, you stay there. You stay there. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Hit one. Oh, it's a slow-moving Armos. That I can deal with. Woo! Alright. Now we got some twitchy twitchies in here. Time to kill them. Before they make me go spazzy spazzy. Alright. Two more twitchy twitchies left to go. Stun him with... I'm gonna kill him with a battle axe. Another super bomb, huh? Oh, that's convenient, I guess. Alright, in here we got some Dodongos. Our last encounter with them... hit the bomb at the wrong angle. Oh, how I hate the Dodongos. It's just annoying to wait for them to turn into your bombs. Boom! Smoked your ass. Boom! Oh, caught two of them. Double kill. Loving it. Alright, up here we got... Oh, boy. Very tricky room. Patra 3 with holes. Yeah. I suggest not moving. Just stay there and tank the damage. Only go straight, because you don't want to suffer knockback in this room. That's bad. Like I said, we got the gold ring, we can take the damage. Oh, did it, did it. Yeah, watch yourself, please. Gonna have to tank this Patrick 3. Got no... God. Oh, did it, did it, did it, did it, did it. Okay, okay, I'm staying against the wall. I don't want to risk it. Fortunately, this Patrick's in a very bad spot. Need him to get to the middle of the room. Over into the middle, dummy! Come on, I'm not risking going over the hole to kill you. Alright, now it's time to go crazy. Hurry! Alright, that was a hard room out of the way. Alright, now we got a rapid-fire Goma next. Yeah, this thing's actually a joke compared to the Patra 3. Alright, dead. Ooh, we got a fairy. Thank you. All right, this next room gonna be quite a nuisance. You want to kill these bat robes quick. The bats are gonna accumulate in this room fast. All right, well, I'm killing quite a bit of them now. This is good. All right, we're down to one bat robe. All right, he's dead now. Good. Throw my battle axe around, do some damage to all these aches. Managed to stay out of the spikes too, which is nice. And there's really not too much more to go, folks. We're nearing the end. It's only a few more rooms and then we're at Volrath. Oh, all right. And here. Okay, we got two Death Knights. Oh, God, yeah, you did it. Potion, don't be afraid to use it. We got it, use it now. And you know what? We got super bombs to spam, let's use them. Oh, crap, you went up. Alright, you know what? I don't care. We don't need super bombs for the rest of the game. Alright, good. Caught him with the battle axe. Okay, now in here we got Neo robes, which is definitely more tolerable. I can save that with a straight face. They only do a heart of damage, so I'm not too worried. I can afford to be a little sloppy on mirror robes now. And after the mirror robes, we'll be at Volrath. Come on. Spam your magic, dang it. Dead. Alright, let's see if I can get these two lined up so I can kill them. Alright, and nope, not quite dead yet, but he should be soon. Alright, dead, and last but not least, gone. And now it's time for Ganon, aka Volrath. Now, you want to get off the spikes. Stay in the middle of the room. You only need two hits on Ganon, so don't try to push your luck getting near the pit. Wait for Ganon to come to you. Alright, dead. And golden arrow finished! Ha ha ha! And that's it, folks. Volrath, aka Ganon, is dead. And now we rescue Smelda. And that is it, folks, for Legend of Zelda Conquest of Sarpadia. Thanks, Link. You are the hero of Sarpadia. Hell's friggin' yeah. And just like that, folks, we are finished with Legend of Zelda Conquest of Sarpadia. Hope you all enjoyed this ZC quest. I know I certainly did. This was one I really had a great time with in the past. I'm so happy to finally be able to finish it and help everyone else who struggled on this game that couldn't beat it. Now you guys have a full complete walkthrough of the game. Anyways, folks, stay tuned for my next Let's Play coming up, 150 if you can believe it, with Katawa Shoujo. I'll be covering Hanako's Path, and I'm so looking forward to getting to that LP. Anyway, stay tuned for that one, and I'll see you all later. Peace, friggin' out. Oh!